In the last video, I gave an introduction to the heap data structure. In this video, I'll show you how to build a heap from an unordered array, specifically a max heap. To do this, we'll cover two methods, max heapify and build max heap. Let's start with max heapify, which does the majority of the work. The goal of max heapify is to maintain the max heap property, which, as we learned in the last video, is that the value of I must be less than or equal to the value of its parent. Another way of looking at this is that the value of I is greater than or equal to the value of its children. We'll use this condition in our demonstration because we'll take a bottom-up approach. Max heapify takes three inputs: an array, heap size, and the index I. Let's take a look at what it does. I'll use the tree representation of a heap because it's easier to follow visually. We'll start with the node on the right, which is the node at index I. With max heapify, we assume the left and right children of this node are already heaps. I's value may be smaller than the left or right child, in which case we have work to do to maintain our heap. If the value of I is indeed smaller, we say that it floats down to its proper place in the tree. One note here, heap size is a parameter because it's useful during heap sort. In building our heap, heap size will just be the length of our array. But in heap sort, heap size decreases as you sort the array. Let's look at two concrete examples. On the left, we have part of a tree, and the node at index I with a value of 21. This node is larger than both of its children, so this is a max heap and we have no work to do. On the right, we see that node I with a value of 9 is breaking the max heap property. Let's take a look at the max heapify code that will fix this. We start by setting the left index, which is 2 times I, and the right index, which is 2 times I plus 1. Let's create a variable called largest and set it equal to I. We then compare the value of I's left child with the value of I, and if it's larger, we set the largest equal to the left child. In this case it is, so we move our largest pointer. We then compare the value of the right child with the value of the largest. 18 is greater than 13, so we set largest equal to the right child. Lastly, we see that the largest is no longer equal to I, so we swap the two values. And finally, we call max heapify with this new index in a recursive manner. You can see how it will float down until it's in its proper place. The running time of max heapify is big O of log n. The comparisons we do run in constant time, but we may call max heapify for each level of the binary tree, which, as you know, has a height of log n. Let's discuss the other method, build max heap, which is a simpler method and really a wrapper function to call max heapify. We'll take a look at build max heap in the context of the following nearly complete binary tree. Basically, we need to know where to start. Which node is our entry port for calling max heapify? To determine this, we can make an observation about the nearly complete binary tree. We know that we can determine the leaves of the tree using this formula. The discovery of this formula is outside the scope of this video, but for now, let's assume it to be true. Looking at our tree, we see that n equals 10. Plugging 10 into the formula, we see that nodes 6 through 10 are leaves. Why is this significant? Since the nodes are leaves and they have no children, they're already heaps. We'll use this knowledge when writing the build max heap code. Here's the code. Let's plug in the calculation based on the specific tree we're looking at to simplify things. In this case, we'll start with a node at index 5 and call max heapify. This is what we mean from a bottom-up approach, as we're not starting with a root. We'll call max heapify on the rest of the nodes, all the way to the root of the tree. Looking at the code, you can see because of our for loop, we have a linear runtime, or big O of n. Here's all the code together, which is on my GitHub and linked in the video description. The last piece of the puzzle is using this to run heap sort, and for that I'll refer you to one of my older videos. Thank you for watching. I hope this video helps you on your computer science journey. Please like and subscribe.